Hello, people. PJ Battler here. So, today I'm reviewing another horrible fanfic that I'm pretty sure we'll all come to hate. This one is called Love at First Sight. Now, this is another one that I found on my very popular SpongeBob forum. And let me just be the one to say it. It's kind of bad. Spelling is definitely off. There's just a whole bunch of things wrong with it. But I'm going to let you guys decide if it's truly bad, because I don't think it's really that bad. Yeah. So, here comes the epic reading by me. This is Love at First Sight. First thing I note is that the quotation mark, the very first quotation mark right over here, first word in the story, is actually just a little dash. That is not the right way to start it. Got it? Honk, honk, honk. SpongeBob's alarm clock went off. SpongeBob hops, long hops. There's another little dash right where it should be. Out of the bed, it should say. Out the bed and heads downstairs. Good morning, Gary. Suddenly, SpongeBob heard the noise of a very large truck. SpongeBob went to the door and opened it. When he looked outside, he saw that there was a new neighbor moving in down the street. Hey, Patrick, come, look. It should say, there shouldn't be a comma between come and look. It should just say, come look. There's someone moving in down the street. Should say there is, or there's. Patrick's rock. Rock does not need to be capitalized. Lifts. Doesn't need to be. My God, there's so many things wrong with this story. Lifts. That little bastard needs to go away. Up, and he falls from the top of it, making a very loud noise as he lands. What is it, SpongeBob? Look, we're getting a new neighbor. Let's. There is not a little dash there. Let's go introduce ourselves. Great. Great is in all capital letters, and that's horrible. And I guess I don't have much room to talk myself, but still. Soon, SpongeBob and Patrick head down the street to go meet their... Oh my God!
Wrong there. I hate that so much.
To meet their, not there, new neighbor. When they got there, their new neighbor was helping move her stuff in. The new neighbor was helping move her stuff in. What? Okay. Technically, the way they're saying it is, this new neighbor was helping move someone's stuff in. It should say, the new neighbor was moving her stuff in. Well, hi there, neighbor. My name is SpongeBob, says SpongeBob with a southern accent. Why is he speaking in a southern accent? He's not from Texas like Sandy. Hi there, my name is Tracy. Tracy Starfish. Now, the genius who wrote this should know that starfish does not have two R's. All of a sudden, Patrick and Tracy meet eyes and started floating towards each other. Hi, my name is Tracy, Tracy Starfish. Didn't you just say that? Tracy said in a flirty voice. My name is Patrick, Patrick Star. Star only has one R. SpongeBob was standing in the middle looking lost. He was trying to figure out what had just happened. Suddenly, he figured it out by the way they were talking to each other and started to laugh with a large grin on his face. Well, I guess I'll leave you two alone. And SpongeBob started to creep off. Let's just stop here. What I just read was one whole gigantic paragraph. Now, I'm pretty sure that the genius who wrote this should know that you don't put all that dialogue in just one gigantic paragraph. That's not how it works. My gosh, how I hate this so much. SpongeBob went to the Krusty Krab for lunch, and soon after he went in, Patrick and Tracy came floating in through the door. This is why periods are important, because that actually makes it sound disgusting. I'm in the middle of a review, do you mind? Jeez. Sorry about that. What are you guys doing here? SpongeBob said with a confused look on his face. Oh, I don't know. I mean, it's a restaurant. Maybe they came here for the mattresses. Where the heck else would they be in a restaurant? We're on our first date. This made SpongeBob even more confused, so he just went home. I don't see what there is to be confused about. Jeez. The next day, SpongeBob woke up and called Patrick, but when he called, Patrick's line was busy. Where is Patrick? Said SpongeBob with curiosity in his voice. Soon, SpongeBob went to Patrick's house and was surprised to see Tracy sitting in the living room. Hi, Tracy. What are you doing here? Waiting on Patrick. We have another date. Tracy had a big smile on her face that made SpongeBob get bad vibes from her. I don't understand that. People can't just smile without being accused of something suspicious. Hi, SpongeBob. Me and Tracy are going on a date. Yes, I heard. Everyone stood there for a while, and soon Patrick and Tracy walked out the door and said bye to SpongeBob. Said bye to SpongeBob and walked out the door. But I don't care, really. SpongeBob stood there realizing that he had nothing to do because he usually spends the day with Patrick, so he went home. SpongeBob decided to call Sandy to see what she was doing. Hello, Sandy, what are you doing? Said SpongeBob. Oh, hi, SpongeBob, I'm getting ready to go to the movies with a friend. SpongeBob asked if he could tag along, but Sandy said no. I don't understand that. Why wouldn't he be allowed to go just... I mean, it's so stupid. It's not that big of a deal if he just, you know, goes hang out with her. How is that such a big deal? Let's see. Oh, crap. Oh, no. Lost my place. Where was I at? Soon, SpongeBob was calling all over PJBottomz to everyone he knew, but everyone had plans. Soon, SpongeBob decided to stay home and watch television. Well. Come on, scroll down. Later that day, SpongeBob heard Tracy and Patrick talking to each other saying goodnight. Should be, and saying goodnight. And saying goodnight. Let's see. SpongeBob thought about what happened earlier and decided to do some investigating. SpongeBob waited till it was dark and snuck out of the house to Tracy's window. Alright, a few things wrong with this paragraph. First off, what happened earlier was all she did was smile. I mean, so someone sitting in a living room smiling while waiting for their date. What is so bad about that? That doesn't even make sense. People are so stupid. Alright. The next thing is, snuck to her window. So, like, does she just live with a... She just, like, live with a window... And only a window. Who cares? When he got there, Tracy was on the phone with someone. Forgot a comma between there and Tracy. Don't worry, I got everything all figured out. Ugh! You guys should know by now that I absolutely hate it when people use all capital letters. He's so dumb. SpongeBob was shocked at what he heard, but just to be sure he listened to the conversation longer. I'm telling you, he has no clue. I'm going to rob him of all he's got, and there's no one that can stop me. Tracy started to laugh evilly, but stopped because she started coughing.
Oh, really? Now, where have we seen that before? Oh, I know. It was in Dunces and Dragons.
And we'll say that's at least good referencing. SpongeBob rushed over to Patrick's house and told him the bad news, but Patrick didn't believe him and put him out.
That should say kicked him out, not put him out. SpongeBob was so heartbroken, he went home crying. Heartbroken is one word, not two words. The next day, SpongeBob woke up and found that Tracy and Patrick were going on another date. So he just randomly hopped out of bed and learned that Tracy and Patrick were going on another date. Oh, let me recreate that. Hey! Tracy and Patrick are going on another date! Come on. Let's see, where was I? So SpongeBob decided to follow them. When did he suddenly become a stalker? After following them all day, SpongeBob saw that Tracy didn't do anything suspicious or evil.
Really?
But he wasn't going to give up that easy on his friend. Soon, SpongeBob went home and got all his spy gear so that he could prove to Patrick that he was telling the truth and waited for the next day. See? That next day, Soon, SpongeBob went home and got all his spy gear. When did SpongeBob get spy gear? My God! Let's see. The next day, Tracy and Patrick went out on another date, and SpongeBob followed them again. This time he was prepared, he had his x-ray goggles and everything. First they went into a restaurant of butt dinner, but soon after their arrival... Oh my God. First they went into a restaurant of butt dinner. What the heck is butt dinner? But soon after there, wrong there. I hate it when people do that. No. Soon after there, not their arrival, Tracy had to make a phone call. SpongeBob followed Tracy to a nearby should be one word. Payphone. Payphone should also be one word, right? Yeah. I'm at dinner with him right now. I know this plan is going to work. Alright, I have to go now. I'll talk to you later. Forgot a period there. SpongeBob recorded the whole conversation. Soon they went to the fair and Patrick bought her a teddy bear. They stayed there until it was dark. SpongeBob left early and waited until Patrick and Tracy went home. When Tracy got home, she had another phone call and SpongeBob was waiting for her by the window. When she was talking to the mysterious person, SpongeBob recorded the whole conversation and he got some good information. When he was through, he ran to Patrick's house, let him listen to the tape and told him what he knew. Patrick was so brokenhearted, heartbroken, and it's one word. God, how stupid are you people? Patrick was so heartbroken and said that he was going to break up with Tracy in the morning. Should say he was so heartbroken that he said he was going to break up with Tracy in the morning. People get it right. The next day, SpongeBob woke up to the phone ringing. He answered it, and it was Patrick telling him to come over. And it was. No, it's just put, period. It was Patrick. SpongeBob went over to Patrick's house, and Tracy was there. What is she doing here? No question mark. I'm breaking up with her. Tracy jumped out of her seat with rage and stormed out of Patrick's house. SpongeBob apologized to SpongeBob and said that a girl would never come between them again. Okay, well, let's see what's wrong with this fanfic. Misspellings, misuse of words, lack of grammar, lack of punctuation, and if there are punctuations, they're put in the wrong spot. And this plot is lame. My mouth is dry now. Well, I have to wrap this up because I'm at the 15-minute mark, but... Make sure you review this yourself if you want to. I'll put a link in the description, which is right down there. And make sure to subscribe. Alright guys, see you later.